Hello, my name is John Payne, TME for Secure Firewall, and in this demo, I will showcase the end-to-end upgrade workflow for FMC and FTD for customers upgrading from the 6.6.1 release to the recommended 7.0.5 release. At the end of this video, I will showcase the user experience upgrading FTD devices to 7.2.1. For this demonstration, a multi-step approach is shown due to the current recommended release being version 7.0.5. However, upgrading from 6.6.1 to the latest long-term release 7.2 is supported. In this setup, a standalone FMC is used. However, administrators have the option to configure FMC in a high availability pair to where no interrupt is observed in the management plane. In a standalone configuration, only an interrupt is noticed at the management plane during the upgrade procedure, while the data plane remains uninterrupted. Regardless of the configuration, the user experience in the upgrade workflow remains the same. It's best to have a recent backup before proceeding. Here we will verify we have a recent backup of the FMC, and for this setup, managed device backups have been sent to a remote storage server. To start the upgrade, we must first upgrade FMC to a higher version than that of the managed devices. Click Updates, and to start the FMC upgrade, we'll click the Install icon next to the version we wish to install, in this case 7.05. Clicking Install will bring you to the next page, to where we can check the box for the FMC and launch the readiness check. This may take a few minutes, and this video has been sped up for brevity. Once the readiness check has completed, click Close and then click Install to begin the upgrade. A warning message will display noting the FMC will reboot during this process. Click OK to acknowledge this warning. Opening up the Message Center, under the Tasks tab, we can see the currently running tasks for the FMC. Here we can track the progress of the FMC upgrade. Now that FMC is rebooted as part of the upgrade process, log in, read and accept the EULA, and navigate to System Configuration to where we can verify that the upgrade was successful. In the FMC configuration window, here we can see that the software version is on 7.0.5. Go ahead and navigate back to the device management page so that we can begin the FTD upgrade. In 7.0.5, customers are able to take advantage of additional feature sets provided in this release along with an enhanced user experience in the FMC. Here we have our same HA pair of FTD devices running software version 6.6.1. Let's begin the upgrade. Go ahead and click the checkbox next to the HA pair and under Select Action, click Upgrade Firepower Software. Starting in 7.0, we introduce the upgrade wizard for ease of managing and deploying upgrades. Here we'll walk through the wizard by first selecting the target upgrade version and clicking Copy Upgrade Package to copy the necessary packages to the managed device. Click Continue and then monitor Message Center to track the progress of copying the upgrade files. Once this completes, you may need to wait for the upgrade wizard to acknowledge the files have been copied to the devices before clicking Next. Here we will run the readiness check on all eligible devices, and once completed, we can continue with our upgrade. With this box checked, the device will automatically return to its pre-upgrade state in the event of a failure. Click Start Upgrade and then click through the wizard to begin this process on the standby node. To ensure no loss of network traffic, the upgrade begins on the standby node. During the process, the roles of the HA pair are changed in order to keep the flow of traffic intact during the upgrade. Monitor the progress of the upgrade in the message center. Policy migration as part of the upgrade procedure is seamless. No user intervention is required as all policies are utilized in the upgraded FMC. There are, however, corner cases where custom IPS rules need to be migrated due to syntax changes, but this only affects a small percentage of customers. Back in the device management page of the FMC, we can see our HA pair is now on version 7.0.5, and the secondary node is now the active node due to the upgrade sequence. Under the Upgrade tab, we can view the upgrade path from 6.6.1 to 7.0.5. Now I'd like to jump to an FMC on version 7.2.1. Because the user experience remains the same as with the upgrade from FMC from 6.6.1 to 7.0.5, I've upgraded this FMC to 7.2.1 for the purposes of this video. Here you will notice the enhanced FMC interface, and we have added features and functionality in addition to those in the 7.0.5 release. With the 7.2 release, we have simplified the upgrade approach by allowing administrators to auto-upgrade the Snort 3 after a successful FTD software upgrade. This workflow is similar to that of the 7.0 release in terms of utilizing the upgrade wizard. So under the device management page, we can select the device, click Select Action, and click Upgrade Firepower Software. Since the devices were already selected in the previous menu, they are pre-populated on the right, and all we have to do is select the target upgrade version to 7.2.1. So the same steps as the 7.0 FMC upgrade wizard. We must first copy the upgrade packages, click Next once the upgrade package has been copied to the device. Version 7.2 introduces the peer-to-peer sync option, where upgrade packages can be copied from device to device. This secure and reliable resource sharing goes over the management network, but does not rely on FMC. Each device can accommodate 5 package concurrent transfers and also is only supported on standalone devices managed by the same standalone FMC. Here we will run the readiness check, click continue, and once completed, click next. What's new with the upgrade wizard in 7.2 is this toggle giving the option to jump right to Snort 3 during the upgrade process. Leave this turned on for all eligible devices to be upgraded to Snort 3 post-upgrade. Click the Start Upgrade button to complete the wizard and monitor the upgrade process through the Message Center. After the upgrade has completed, head back to the Device Management page, where we can see that devices have upgraded to 7.2.1 and also upgraded to Snort 3. I hope this was informative, covering end-to-end upgrade process for both FMC and FTD. Thank you.